I am honored to address this distinguished group of peacemakers from all walks of life and all parts of the world. I congratulate the World Peace Partnership for organizing this conference and believe that you that peace starts with all of us. As UN Women, the newly established United Nations entity for gender equality and the empowerment of women, we also believe that women and girls, men and boys, all have a role in the process of the world in reconsidering peace from conflict prevention to recovery. Engaging women fully in all stages of peace and recovery process is one of the five strategic priorities of our new strategic plan. We are also, however, also depends on realizing the other four, advancing women's economic empowerment and political leadership, ending violence against women and girls, and integrating women and gender equality priorities into all aspects of national development planning and budgeting. Our approach to peace and security begins with Security Council Resolution 1425, which both recognized the impact of war on women and highlighted their contributions to conflict resolution and empowerment. It acknowledged that the differential impact of conflict on women and men requires gender-specific response to the needs during and after. In the past 3 years, the Council has adopted several new resolutions on sexual violence in conflict, driven by the horrific incidents of sexual violence in conflict and the threat it presents to national recovery. Now, they, and all of us, need to invest in women as agents of peace. The World Bank report on conflict, security, and development argues that the key to sustainable peace lies in citizen security, addressing injustice, and creating empowerment, all of which are also essential to economic development, good governance, and political legitimacy. Many women believe that if women were fully engaged in all of these aspects of peace building, they would help prevent impunity that undermines efforts to reestablish the rule of law. In the realm of justice, if sexual violence in conflict were more often tried as a war crime than the reparations paid to its victims, it would protect their citizenship rights and strengthen the rule of law. In the realm of economic recovery, if women were treated equally in efforts to rebuild livelihoods, including equal access to employment opportunities, it would speed the process of rural recovery and security. Finally, in government, if women were engaged in public decision making and employed in public administration, we would see more diversity expressed in policy making and more attention to community and family needs. Work is just a fraction of what we currently spend on disarmament, globalization, and reintegration were spent on providing women with access to land, credit, and training. We know that there are important differences in the ways men and women stand by. Would we see a more rapid rate of recovery in rural communities? What if there were significant investments in community security so that women can receive funding for market activities in those fields of care? Would we see more families preparing and more women running for local council? Women, it is well known, invest in a majority of the income in the families they went to more teaching schools, houses in care, healthier families. We know that women can make a big difference to sustainable peace. For this to happen, women must be part of the process from the beginning. They cannot be credible participants if they are brought into a process where the rules have already been agreed without them. Yet, a review of peace process of over the last 2 decades found that women average fewer than 8% of negotiating teams, and no women have been chief mediators or UN managed peace process. A study of 500 mediatorial peace accords between 1990 and 2010 found that only 16% contain any reference to women's role. Last year, the UN system committed to providing gender expertise to peace talks and post-conflict processes, including technical assistance and the use of temporary special measures, such as quotas, to increase women's representation. This provides an opening which we must all take. We welcome the work that the World Peace Partnership is doing to ensure some people are even at negotiating tables. I look forward to partnering with you in this worthy endeavor. Thank you very much.